Hi, so I'm lucky enough to have one of these Brian May Red Special guitars that, as you can see, is signed. Now what was happening was that the down here, you'll see as I was playing it, despite me trying to cover it with kitchen film, the signature's starting to wear off. So what I've done is I've got a piece of perspex and I've put it on over the top. And that is going to protect the guitar going forward and makes it look a lot better on the wall, because I had a bit of film covering it originally. So I just put a little video together to show you how that I attach the perspex in case you want to try that yourself. So the first thing you need to do, of course, is decide what perspex you want. This is the perspex I got from Amazon. So as it turned out, this seems to be perfect. So you might want to get something similar.
Hi, this is my first YouTube video. I've not tried one of these before, so what I'm going to try and do is, I've bought a Brian May guitar, which I'm very pleased about, and I'm just in the process, because it was a signed one, of seeing if I can protect the signature. So I did a temporary fix with film, this stuff, which is the signature's still wearing off if I play it. So what I've done is I've bought some thin, clear plastic. I'm going to try and cut into shape to see if that will help. So what I've done already is I've just taken a little bit of the plate off, taken this plate off, a couple of screws there, and then I'm just using a piece of A3 paper, put it on, measure it out, and you can see I'm just in the process of creating a template in paper. I've loosened the screws here on this plastic scratch guard. I'm going to aim to try and slip this very thin plastic underneath, like so, when I cut it. I mean, I don't know whether this is going to work, but we'll see how it goes. And the aim is to cut it so it fits all the way around here, and then we'll see how we get on. So I'm going to try and cut this out, and then we'll have another look in a minute. So you can see I've done most of the major cutting out, which is not quite right. So I just need to play with the template a bit. Ideally, I want these bits to slide under the plastic guard so that they'll hold in place when I'm finished. But you'll see there isn't much space around here. So I might have to do some refining on the actual piece of plastic rather than on the paper. But that is not looking too bad at the moment. I'll need to consider whether this piece, I'm actually gonna try and screw through the plastic, or whether I'm gonna cut round. That'll probably depend how the plastic itself cuts when I come to use it. So I'll keep trimming for a moment and we'll come back and see where we get to. What I'm just trying now, because the paper's cut, is I'm just seeing what'll happen if I lift these screws. Now, I don't want to take the whole of the scratch plate off, because God knows what will fall apart if I do that. I'm not touching these, which are holding the pickups in. I'm just trying to loosen the edge, and the hope is that this side of the finger plate will lift. You see I've done it here, I don't know if you can see that's lifting, and then just slide that underneath to get me a better idea of how it's going to sit, which is not too bad actually. Clearly it will depend on how thick the plastic actually is when I do that. Now when I come around to do this other side, I'm going to have to think about that a bit more, because there's more switches, more things on the base plate here, and what I don't want to do is start taking the whole guitar apart, because I'm not a guitar builder. So we'll see what happens with that. So let me just carry on a little bit more and trim this paper up here, and then we'll see where we get to with the template. Here we go, you can see now that the paper template's really covered quite well. It has actually slid underneath these sides. I'm not going to lift that side yet, because what I think I'll do is I'll cut the plastic and make sure. Now what I've got to do is obviously I don't quite know how this plastic is going to cut, so it could be, I'm going to try with scissors first. If I get a Sharpie with this, lay it over the top of the plastic, then hopefully it will give me a good idea of what this is going to look like. So, fingers crossed. Okay, so next stage, which is the bit I'm probably most nervous about, is this plastic is covered with a blue covering, clear underneath. Obviously, because it'd be rubbish if I covered the signature up with a blue. So, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to stick this down on here, and I'm using a Sharpie, try and I'll just tack this. What I'm going to try and do is draw around it and then try cutting it. Cutting it could do anything because I've not used this plastic before. It could split, it could crack, all sorts of things it could do, so I just need to be slightly careful about how I do it. This bit here I'm going to cut wider and then trim afterwards because it's so narrow there's a danger I'll make a mistake if I do this wrong. So I'm gonna probably cut this out as a chunk and then measure it again afterwards. It's probably enough in space, so let's give it a go. Here is to make it too big, so draw reasonably a long way inside the line so that you can see how much extra you're giving it. Some bits around here I'm a bit more comfortable with, but I think let's go larger first and then see where we get to. This bit I've left tight. And here I'll just do a bit more. Okay, moment of truth. So remove the template. What I might do is just match that against the guitar, which I've got down on the floor down here. See the guitars, just stand it up. I'm just going to do a quick measure to see how it looks. So, yeah, that's quite good because you can see it through. So I think that's probably going to work. Okay, let's try cutting. See how we get on. Right, so the first thing I'm going to do, this is the test. I'm going to cut this corner. Hopefully it will cut like paper, in which case we're in business. Let's try. I've left the protective covering on. It's quite tight to cut, but actually is cutting quite smoothly. Doesn't seem to be any splits or cracks. Yeah, you see that? That's cut quite nicely, and actually the thing I'm reassured about is it's not sharp either, there's no rough edge. Right, so I'll carry on cutting around and I'll show you the result. Okay, so here's the very rough cut that I've done. So you see I've not cut this bit out yet, nor the edge. What I'm just going to do is I'm then going to just check it against the guitar to make sure that I've not made a mistake. So here we go. Yeah, it's close. I'm going to have to be careful now because I think one of the things that the marking shows me is there isn't much room for error. You want the plastic to go to the edge and fit around the curves and slide underneath. This is going to have to be quite exact. And this bit here, this bit is going to have to be really narrow. So we have made some progress. So I've managed to cut this bit fine enough so it wedges under the guitar, which is... Now the only thing I'm not sure about is whether that will affect the way the guitar plays, because clearly it's lifting the whammy bar, so I may have to... I suspect it will push the guitar out of tune, so I may trim that. But when it's flat it may not make a difference, look, because there's still some... You can see some movement there. Not quite in tune then, so... That's something I can always trim finer later, but of course the trick with this is not to cut it too small, because you can't add back on, you can only trim down. So what I need to do now is I need to get this bit, which is pushing up, I need to trim this in, because if I can do that, then I should be able to get a better view of how it's going to sit on the guitar. So I'll keep you posted. So I've just put this back in. What I'm going to do is just try and measure where the edge of the plate is, which I think is here, so I can cut it and and cut this bit out here because it's pushing the guitar up. So I need to push, I need to cut that bit out there. So you can see what I'm doing is I'm doing little bits at a time to try and be careful because it's easy to make a mistake with this. So you can see I've just highlighted a little bit I want to cut out so it sits flatter on the guitar. So you can see how I'm cutting now, I'm just cutting a chunk out, like I said, I'm cutting a bit more because I want it to sit flatter on the guitar. You see it actually cuts quite easily. And obviously I can't guarantee that any plastic you buy will cut like this, but this thickness, it seems to be okay. The thing I thought I'd show you is how I'm putting it back in. So what I'm doing is I'm putting it in at an angle, so I'm putting the short side in first underneath the whammy bar space and then twisting it and then just sliding it in, lining up this edge at the end and then the side edge, so that's the edge of the original piece of plastic, so it gives me an idea of what sort of size I'm doing. And now actually you can see starting to sit on reasonably well, so feeling a bit more positive that it might work. I think the key problem is how am I going to slide it under all the plastic here. Now what I could do is I could slide it all the way under and then try and put the screws back through the plastic. And obviously I'm going to try in a minute just to see how this should, another bit of plastic with maybe this plate on, just see how easy it is to screw through. So let's just have a look at that now, because if it'll go quite a long way underneath and you can screw through it, that will make your life a lot easier. What I need to do, get a cork mat I've got for my drink, let's just see, get my Phillips screwdriver, let's just see how that sits. If I push it in, how easy is it to screw through this plastic? I'm putting medium pressure on, not too hard. Actually, let's see that. The screw's just coming through and it's actually gone through quite easy. I'll just push it all the way through to check it doesn't split. Now actually, it goes through really easily. So in theory then, I should just be able to put the plates, once I've taken the blue off, I should be able to put the plates back on over the top, and it will protect, it will mean I don't have to cut so much, and hopefully it will protect a bit more of the guitar and the signature. So that feels quite positive. So what I might do now is remove the screws that I can from here in a minute. I've done that already. I'll cut these as close as I can to the edge now and then see if I can slide underneath a bit further than I was going to, and that might make my life a lot easier. It would mean I only need to cut where it's catching the neck of the guitar and the pickup, and it will just sit underneath. Now obviously the big thing is whether any of this will alter the tone of the guitar. I'm not a very good player, so it probably won't matter to me. If you are, if you do love the tone of your guitar, you might just want to think about the easier thing to do. If you want to protect the signature on the guitar, not play the guitar, get a different guitar. Okay, I'm going to trim some butt out and I'll come back in a minute. Right, so I can see the line I've just drawn here. Clearly, you might want to use a different pen so you don't get confused, but yeah, I'm comfortable which line I need to cut here. I'm going to cut that and see how it works. One thing to look for if you're cutting with scissors is I've just cut here. Just cut here, and I've cut down there. Now, if I try and move the scissors that way, what I'm doing is I'm bending the card, bending the plastic, so it might make it ripple, which would be rubbish when I put it back on the guitar. So you can either cut this bit when you're having to do that, or spin it, just a simple thing to do. Come at it from the other side and meet the cut that you've already made. And in that way, you're much less likely to buckle the plastic. Just be careful when you're cutting back towards a bit you want to keep. Go quite slowly because the scissors can jump. There we are. So you've cut that back in. Not quite close enough. What I'm going to do is just use my craft knife now on a bit of cork just to slice it out. Just here, so. Just to make sure I don't need to use the scissors. So you just push down on it and it will come out. Alright, so I've got a little bit more to just cut off here, which is going to be interesting with the scissors, so just let me have a go at that. But this, I think, I'm going to need to get at it from this side it's quite close to where I don't want to damage it, so it's going to be quite a delicate cut. Yeah, the plastic, I'm just putting a little bit of, what I'm doing is now I'm bending this as a sideways to avoid the problem I had before of cutting plastic. Now, there we go, just take it up to an edge. There we go. Okay, right, let's try that back in. Remember, I'm trying it in, sliding it in from an angle and then pulling it back round so it sits. This is already looking better. Yeah, that doesn't look bad at all, actually. I'm quite pleased with that. Now, the question is, can I actually, while I'm doing that, get it to slide under this bit of the finger guard? So that is going to be a bit more challenging. But if I use another bit of the plastic that I've cut off, slide that here underneath, that won't damage the guitar like a screwdriver would. So I'll just use that to lift it. Now you see what I'm doing as I'm sliding it in, it's sliding underneath all the way across now. That I am quite pleased with. Look at that, now you can see. Basically the whole of the bottom of the guitar is going to be covered in clear plastic, which is going to completely protect the signature. I don't know if you can just see it pushing through there. That would be great. The key now is to make sure that I'm really careful getting an edge, because if I get a rough edge around here, that will make the guitar not very good to play. So now it's locked in and it's in the right position. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take the Sharpie and colour in exactly where the edge is. Luckily, you can just make out where the white edge of the guitar is. So hopefully Mr. May's signature is not going to get damaged during the next part of this process. So I'm not going to show you. I'll pause for a minute while colour that in. And this makes me think I might want a coffee too. So see you in a minute. See what I mean? Mug of coffee. Let's carry on with the marking of the plastic as to exactly where I need to cut out. Now it's in and under, I'm going to have to be really careful about making sure I get exactly to the edge. So this is probably, after all I've done so far, this is probably the most critical bit, the marking and the colouring there. Right, so again, sorry this is all reversed, but what you can see here is the I've marked out the bit I need to cut and I've hatched it so that I can see, because there's more than one line, exactly where I'm going to cut. So I'm going to take it all out now, and now I'm going to spend the next few minutes carefully cutting around this and then hoping it's going to be right. So cross fingers. So an update, I've done most of the cutting now. I still haven't lifted this plate, so it's going to have to sit over that, but again going in sideways. Now I can slide it under this bit that I've just loosened the screws on. Just get it to sit. And there we are. Not far off. The edge isn't, it looks, you can see that it overlaps a little bit at this corner here now, so I need to do a little bit of trimming and organising, but I might be able to move it across a bit. I think I need to take a fraction off here, which I can mark. This is looking alright around here. Remember that it will be clear when it's on, so you can see it's not looking too bad at the moment. I'm going to have to work out how I attach this bit round here. I may have to put a tiny bit of clear sealant on the edge just to hold that bit down. But generally, I'm feeling quite positive at the moment. Probably didn't do a great job on this bit round here, but hopefully if I do a little bit of trimming and smoothing, it will look okay. That there, this bit definitely is, and I need to work out if I can slide. I'm going to loosen the screws here and then see if this will slide under, so let me just remove it. Because ideally everywhere it sits under the plate, then it's held in place and I don't need to worry about how I'm going to secure it. Although clearly I've got three screws from this that are going to hold it in place as well, but I'll do those last. So now the trick with this is, as I found here with the screws on this, if you're undoing the screws to just loosen the plate, I wouldn't take all of the screws out. There's probably two screws here that actually hold the plate. These screws are holding the switches in, so they would lift. So you just need to loosen this one about halfway, and that one about halfway, and hopefully what that will do is I can find with a bit of plastic that will just give me enough, yeah, get you some lift, enough to slide underneath, you see? So that's fine. Okay, so we're nearly there. I'm quite pleased with it now. I trimmed a little bit more of the edge of this around here, so it's sat under a bit nicer. And now it sits perfectly nicely all the way around. There's a little bit extra I'm just gonna mark with a Sharpie. So I need to take some off here, like that. And this corner here, I need to take some off. Be careful not to get Sharpie on the guitar. I would not be happy. And here as well. So anywhere where it sits over the edge of the guitar, I just need to move it back in a bit. Other than that, I think we're fine. So there's just a few tiny bits. There's this bit here, and just a little trim around there, which I'll do with the scissors, I think. I'll just do that carefully. And then we're into the final taking off of the film and putting it on and see what it looks like. So, cross fingers. Okay, so just done that. Again, just gonna lift the finger plate here that I've loosened a bit. Slide it under this side as well. So it slides under. You can see how it's just sliding in there, nice and easy. I'm just lying it up. Yeah, that's good. So at the moment, you'll see that it comes close to the edge in some pieces and not so close in other pieces. And I'm hopeful that when I actually take the blue and the white off, it'll be clear. You won't actually notice that because it's going to be so close to the nice pinstriping on the edge of the guitar. But that is even sitting quite flat as well now, so I might just need a tiny bit of beading around the edge later on to try and fix that. So I think I'm ready to peel off the covering and try and put it back in. This is the big test. Obviously what I'll need to do is make sure the guitar is absolutely free of dust and dirt underneath where I'm going to put it, and of course I've got to remember to take this film off, but that's firstly. Hope this peels off as I expect it to. Let's do the white side. Actually, let's do the white side last because that's what's going to slide on. And what I'll do actually is I'm going to go wash my hands because they've got some dirt on them now from doing this. So I'm just going to wash my hands. So just get a bit of kitchen paper. Clearly, I'm not going to get everything off. This is going to have some static on it. But the aim here is not to get a guitar with no dust on it ever. It's to end up with a guitar where the signature doesn't wear off. I kept that probably in the 6 months, that signature will be gone. So here we go, let's see if I can peel this off. Let's peel the any side. Ah, it's like trying to find the end of a roll of sellotape. Never find it. And that's the white started there. I'll come back to that in a second. I just need to find somewhere where there's a bit of blue. Doesn't want to come up, does it? Give me a minute. Oh, there we go, it's going. Here we go. Oh, we're on our way. Right. I'll carry on doing that. And I'll let you know I've finished. Okay, so you can see the blue coming off now. It's a bit difficult to make sure it's all off. Like this, that. Now then, that's a clean surface. Get the white off, and hopefully you'll see how clear this is. There is a slight sharpness to the edge. Which I'm hoping I won't notice when it's on the guitar. If I do, then I may have to do some slight sanding of the edge, being careful not to scratch the main guitar. So, here we go. As far as you can see, that's absolutely clear, which is great. So I'm getting fingerprints on it, so let's use the cloth. Okay, merely the final test. That's the side that's going on first, so again, same routine. So this is one of the reasons why it's good to have done it a few times. Oh, that's actually, it's nice. It's actually sticking to the guitar. Oh, sticking to the film, okay. I'm gonna leave the cling film underneath on the kitchen for film. Because what I'll do is I'll remove it when this is in place, so I'm not pushing that over the signature. And that I am very happy with. Look at that. You can see the signature here, which is completely protected. I've got a few things to do. I've got to put this plate back on, I've got to put these screws back down. If I just line this up, and then what I will do is I will remove the kitchen film I have protecting the signature. That I am very happy with. So there's just the point about how am I going to make this stick around this edge, which I'll have a think about. I'll go to the DIY and see what clear, fine adhesive I can put on that. Right, so if I now tighten these screws down, that should hold it in place. Very pleased with. Put this one in here. Well, that should hold that. So those are all the screws I've put in so far are the screws that are going straight into the main body of the guitar. They're not going through the new plastic covering. So let's see how we get on. Well, that should at least hold it in place. Great, it's not going anywhere. Look at that. Very pleased with that. And then, so it doesn't matter how much now my arm is covering up, because that's, and I don't even think it shows that much. There's a little bit of a line here, which you can see. There's a tiny little line there, but very hard to see. I'm super pleased with that. And obviously what I won't know is how this will scratch and mark over time, but what I do know now is that I could replace it if I had to. Yeah, so that's cheered me up. Now the last piece of the jigsaw puzzle is to put in the plates and the screws that are going to go through the plastic. So what I'll do is I'll do the ones on this first. And you've got to be extra careful now, because obviously if the screwdriver slips, I've got to put a bit more pressure than I normally would. There we go, that's going through nicely. That's going in without any issue. So this plastic is really held down nicely now. Lovely. One here. The only thing I've got left is the final plate. Now with this one actually, you've just got to be a little careful, because if you do it wrong and it's not completely lined up with the hole underneath, then what will happen is that you will make the hole in the wood too big. So just try and make sure that you're properly lined up with the plastic and the plate. And as you're screwing it down, make sure you're not distorting the plastic, which currently it looks okay and it's going in absolutely fine. Now what I have is, so far, and I'm just, that still lifts, so you do have to be careful with that. Okay. And clearly dust will get under here, so. But that is now all done apart from this plate, which is going to sit back on there like it did originally. And that is something that I am very pleased with. what I'll probably do now actually is I'm just going to make some little indentations in here where the actual screw hole is, because that will give the screw that I'm putting in something to bite into and make sure it goes exactly in the right place. As this is completely, when I initially put it on, it's going to be completely free. Unlike the large plate, which was already held in place. But just to make sure that these go in the right place, just some little indentations with the screws. Okay, keep getting rid of the dust. Here we go, first one. Okay, I'll just put these in and then I'll show you the end result in a second. Right, it's just the last tightening of this last screw, and it's all done, and I'm super happy with that. So, there we go.
So, thanks very much. Here it is, up on the wall. Hope you found that helpful.